Okay, now let us take one another example. So in this particular example, we have to find the exponential Fourier series for the given periodic signal. So this signal is an it's a periodic signal which is repeating its value like this. Suppose I'm starting from this point. So this signal is like this for this time interval. Again, it is having a similar pattern for the next time interval. So we can see here that for this is how much time? One, minus two, minus one. So this is one. So for every 1 second, we can say for every 1 second, this signal is repeating its value. So what is the time period here for the given signal? 1 second. Okay. So the time period is 1 second. And the signal is a periodic one. Now, what is the expression of the signal? This signal is not a rectangular one, not as a square wave. It seems like it is an exponential. And also in this given waveform, it is mentioned that it is e raised to power minus t. So it is very clear that the given waveform is an exponential function, and it is a periodic one for the time interval 1 second. It means after every 1 second, this signal is repeating its value. Okay, so how to find the exponential Fourier series? As we have seen, that we have to follow some steps. So the step number one, is what? Define or express x of t in mathematical form. In a mathematical form. Okay, so the step number one kya hai hamara? Hamara jo diya hua signal x of t, uska hum mathematical equation likhenge yahan par. Because we need that x of t to find the Fourier coefficient. So first of all, we have to write down here x of t is mathematical equation. So x of t is already given. It is an exponential, that is e raised to power minus t. So it is defined already, it is e raised to power minus t. But this is the definition of x of t for one time period, So what is the time period here? Let us assume that for 0 to 1 second. We can assume 1 to 2 also. We can assume for minus 2 to minus 1 also. For the sake of convenience, let us assume that for 0 to 1 second. Okay, so time interval for 0 to 1 second. As you can see, for every next 1 second, it is like e raised to power minus t only. So I have defined it is x of t equals to e raised to power minus t for the time 0 to 1 second. Okay, so this is your mathematical definition of the given x of t. Now the step number 2, we will find the Fourier coefficients. So here it is asked to find the exponential Fourier series. So we will find what? Cn. So that Cn is calculated as integration of given x of t multiplied with e raised to power minus jn omega naught t with respect to time. And the limit is, by formula, it is 0 to t naught and 1 upon t naught. Here already we have calculated this t naught to be 1 second from the given waveform. So we have already defined the time period. So now let us put the value of x of t and value of t naught. So what is t naught value? It is 1. So I will write here 1, 0 to 1. What is x of t for this time interval 1 second? It is e raised to power minus t. So I will write here e raised to power minus t, e raised to power minus jn omega naught t with respect to time. Now we have to further find the integration. So now these two are multiplied together. So base are same. So power will be added together. So I will write it like this, e raised to power and then minus t minus. So here t. So I will take t outside and minus in bracket minus 1 plus jn omega naught t. So I have taken minus t common. As you know, base are same, then this 2 power will be added. After addition, I am taking this minus t as a common. Okay, so I think just compare these two part, you will get clear. You will clear about how I have written this. Okay, now find the integration of this exponential function. So e raised to power minus 1 plus j n omega naught t, and divided by minus 1 plus j n omega naught, and the limit is from 0 to 1. Okay, now place one by one upper limit and the lower limit. This part I am taking outside, minus 1 upon 1 plus j n omega naught. Okay, so I have taken this j n omega naught outside. Now place the upper limit and the lower limit. So upper limit is 1, so e raised to power minus 1 plus j n omega naught, and here it is 1, and minus e raised to power minus 1 plus j n omega naught, and here t, at the place of t I have to place 0. So this is going to be complete 0. So e raised to power 0 is 1. So minus 1 upon 1 plus j n omega naught, in bracket it is e raised to power minus 1 plus j n omega naught, here it is 1. Okay, so till this step it is all clear how to find how we have calculated the values. Okay, then now the next we have to simplify it. Since omega naught t naught equals to 2 pi, as we know this, okay, for one time period it is omega naught t naught equals to 2 pi. Since t naught is 1, so I will place this t naught value here 1. This implies what? Omega naught equals to 2 pi. So in this expression, whenever wherever the omega naught is there, I will place 2 pi directly. Okay, so let us see in the next step. Okay, so now we will place the value of omega naught equals to 2 pi in the above expression, and that is written as, that can be written as minus 1 upon 1 plus j n, at the place of omega naught I have to place 2 pi here, and in the bracket e raised to power, okay, minus in bracket 1 plus j n 2 pi, and then minus 1. Okay, so we have reached up to this step. Now we have to further simplify it. So let us see how to simplify. 1 plus j 2 pi n. Here we can write it like e raised to power minus 1. Now we will split this bracket. So this is minus and then minus. So I can write my e raised to power minus 1, then e raised to power minus into this. Minus j 2 n pi and minus 1. Okay. Now we will see the value of this much part. Since e raised to power j theta is cos theta plus j sin theta. We know this. Okay, so this expression is, this expression e raised to power j theta can be written as cos theta plus j sin theta. So here it is e raised to power j, therefore e raised to power minus j 2 n pi can be written as cos. See, other than j, minus 2 n pi is now treated as theta. So I will write here minus 2 n pi plus j sine in bracket minus 2 n pi. Okay, now let us see the value of this part. As you know, cos minus theta is cos theta. So I will write it cos 2n pi. Here sine minus theta minus come outside. So I am writing a minus. Plus is there. So minus into plus minus j sine 2n pi. Okay, now we know that cos 2n pi value is how much? What is cos pi? Minus 1. And what is cos 2 pi? 1. Okay, so cos pi is minus 1 and cos 2 pi is 1. And since here n is multiplied with 2, so this number is an even number. It means if you place here value of n equals to 0, it becomes cos 0, that is 1. If you place the value of n equals to 1, it becomes cos 2 pi. So cos 2 pi is again 1. If you are placing the value of n equals to 2, it becomes cos 4 pi. So anyhow, by placing any value of n is now here integer. So you can place 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Just check it. By putting any value of n here, this is going to be an even number. So cos, this 2n is an even number. So cos even multiple of pi is always 1. And sine 2n pi. Sine 2n pi is how much? See, sine pi is 0, sine 2 pi is 0. So sine value for any integral of pi is always going to be 0. Whether it is even or odd, it is every time going to be 0. Only the thing is, for the case of cos, if it is the odd multiple of pi, it is going to be minus 1. And if it is even multiple of pi, it is going to be plus 1. So here this number 2n is a even number. So this is even multiple of pi. So cos 2n pi is 1. So here 1 is there and minus, here it is 0. So therefore e raised to power minus j 2n pi is going to be 1 only. So we have simplified this value. This is 1. So I will place at this place. So this is what now we have, as we have calculated, it is 1. So now we can again write this cn equals to minus 1 upon 1 plus j 2 pi n, and in bracket it is e raised to power minus 1. This value is 1, already we have calculated here, and here it is 1. Okay, so now how much we have obtained here? Now in your calculator you can calculate this value, e raised to power minus. Okay, so e raised to power minus 1, e raised to power minus 1 minus, and finally minus 1, we will get some numerical value. Okay, and that numerical value multiplied with minus 1 is going to be 0.632 upon 1 plus j 2 pi n. So this is our Fourier coefficient cn. Just calculate this value with the help of calculator. Okay, and after calculating this value, you have to minus with 1. You will obtain some constant value here, and then multiply with minus 1, you will get this much value. Okay, just check it. Okay, now I have written directly here, okay, with the help of calculator. Just check it once whether it is right or wrong. You know how to find. You have to simply find e raised to power minus 1 from the calculator, put that value here and minus with 1, and then multiply with minus 1, you will obtain this cn value. Therefore, the exponential Fourier series x of t can be expressed with the help of exponential Fourier series as summation n equals to minus infinity to plus infinity, here cn e raised to power plus j n omega naught t. So just place the value of cn here. The value is 0.632 divided by 1 plus j